Hello everyone, in previous class we were discussing 7-8 problems of exercise 5.3. So today I will continue with the 10th problem. Okay, so what they have given in 10th problem? Show that in 10th problem, show that A1, A2 to AN form an AP where AN is defined as below. So here 10th point first one. So here AN is defined as follows. AN is equal to 3 plus over N. So if n is defined as n is equal to 3 plus 4n, we have to show that this forms an AP and also find the sum of the first 15 terms in each case. So here we have to find out S15 value, sum of first 15 terms. Okay, so now we have to show that this AN value forms an AP. To prove that, what we have to do? First we have to form an AP. How we can create one AP? By using this AN value. So here in the place of N, first I will found out A1 value, 3 plus 4 into bracket, n value is 1, means here 4 into n means 4 into 1. So I can get the value of a1. They have given an value as 3 plus 4n. So I have to create one AP. I have to create AP, means I have to calculate a1, a2, a3, a4 values to create an AP. So here to get A1, what we can do? 3 plus 4n means n value is 1 only, so 4 into 1. Here 4 into 3 plus 4 into 1 means 4. 4 plus 3, how much we will get? 7. Okay, in next step we will calculate A2. So 3 plus 4n means 3 plus 4 into n value is 2, therefore 4 into 2. Therefore, 3 plus 4 into 2 means 8. Is equal to 8 plus 3 means 11. Like that only I will calculate A3 value. 3 plus 4 into n value is 3 now. 3 plus 4, 3 is 12. 3 plus 12 means how much I will get? 15. Like that only I will calculate A4 value. 3 plus 4 into n value is 4 now. So 3 plus 4 into 4 means 16. 16 plus 3 means how much I will get? 19. These are the 4 terms of AN series. This AN series 3 plus 4n. Okay. So now we have to prove this series 7, 11, 15, 19. These numbers form an arithmetic progression. How to prove that? We will calculate D value, or we will check D value. So D is equal to A2 minus A1. What is the A2 value? 11 minus A1 value is 7. 11 minus 7 means 4. Right? So now again D is equal to A3, next value A3 minus A2. A3 value is 15, A2 value is 11. 15 minus 11 means 4. Again D is equal to next term A4 minus A3. A4 is 19 minus A3 is 15, which is equal to 4. Therefore common difference or D is सेम और कॉन्स्टेंट, therefore this series or given number of the given list of numbers are arithmetic progressions. Now we have to calculate just 15 values, sum of 15 terms. So here to calculate SN value, what is the formula? N by 2 into bracket 2a plus n minus 1 into d. Right? So here, what is the n value? We have to calculate S 15 value. Therefore, SN means S 15. Therefore, n value is 15 only. 15 by 2 into bracket 2 into, what is the a value here? A value means first term. You all know what is the first term here? 7. 2 into 7 plus n value is 15. 15 minus 1 into d. What is the d value? Here we have calculated d value is 4. So 15 minus 1 into 4. Now next step, what we can do? 15 divided by 2. 2 into 7 means how much I will get? 14 plus 15 minus 1 means how much? 14. 14 into 4 means 56. So now in next step, what we can do? 15 divided by 2 into 14 plus 56 means how much we will get? 14 plus 56 means 70. So now I will divide this 70 by 2. Here it will be 2, 3 is 6, 1 is remaining, becomes 10, means 2 by the 10. So 15 into 35. So what is the value? We will get 15 into 35 means, here I will write it directly, 15 into 35 means we will get 525 as the answer. So here sum of 15 terms is 525. So what is the problem they have given? They have given anth term as 3 plus 4n, and we have to prove that this forms an AP, arithmetic progression, and we have to calculate S 15 also. So first we have to prove this forms an AP. To do that, we have to calculate 4 terms of this series a1, a2, a3, a4. How we can calculate? I will consider this n value as 1 to get the value of a1. Like that only I will calculate a2, a3, a4 values. So we got the values as 7, 11, 15, 19. So now to prove this is the arithmetic progression, we have to calculate d value also. How to calculate d value? a2 minus a1 and a3 minus a2, a4 minus a3. So here we got the value as 4. Therefore d value is same for the given list of numbers. Therefore this is the arithmetic progression. Now we have to calculate S 15 value, means sum of 15 terms. To calculate that formula is SN is equal to n by 2 into bracket 2a plus n minus 1 into d. So here I will consider SN as S 15, means n value becomes 15 only. Here 15 by 2. So next 2 into a means a is the first term. What is the first term here? First term of arithmetic progression, 7. So 2 into 7 plus n minus 1. N minus 1 means I consider n value as 15. Therefore 15 minus 1 and d. What is the d value here? 4. So here it is 4. Next step, 15 by 2 into bracket 2 into 7 means 14 plus 15 minus 1 means 14. 14 into 4, 56. Therefore 15 by 2 into 14 plus 56 means 70. Therefore here I can divide this 70 by 2. How much I will get? 35. And now
I will multiply 15 by 35. 15 into 35 means I will get answer as 525, which is the sum of 15 terms. Okay, like this only try to calculate second problem of the 10th minute. So now I will discuss 11th problem.
So in 11th problem, what they are asking?
Question number 11.
If the sum of the first n terms, sum of first n terms means Sn of an AP 4n minus n square. In an AP, sum of first n terms is equal to 4n minus n square. 4n minus n square. We have given sum of first n terms as 4n minus n square. This is Sn value. What is the first term? What is this? First term means we can calculate Sn value. First term means what is that? A1 or A value is considered as first term. So here we can calculate S1 by using this. S1 means, what do you mean by S1? Sum of first term. So there will be only one term, means A1 is the S1. Always A1 equals to S1. How? A1 means first term only and S1 means sum of first term. So we are adding only one term only, therefore S1 is equal to A1 only. See here, for example, your first term A1 is equal to 7. This is for example, A1 is equal to 7. Here they have given 7, 11, 15, 19. This is the series. Here A1 is 7 because first term is 7. Okay. Now, if you want to calculate S1, S1 means sum of first term, therefore S1 is also equals to 7 only. Right? So now we can write A1 is equal to S1. Always in all arithmetic progressions, A1 is equals to S1. A1 means first term, S1 means sum of first term. So these are equal to each other. Here also you got A1 as 7 and S1 is also 7 only. Now, suppose for example, again consider here A2 is in this series, A2 is 11. Right? Second term is 11. So, can we say S2 is also equal to 7? Sorry, S2 is also equal to 11? No, you cannot say. Why? S2 is the sum of A1 plus A2. S2 means sum of two terms, sum of first two terms, S2 means. S1 means sum of first term. S3 means sum of first three terms. Like that only, Sn means sum of first n terms. Now, if A1 is equal to S1, can we say A2 is equal to S2? We cannot say. Why? A2 means 11 here and S2 is the sum of first two terms, A1 plus A2. Here in this example, what is A1 value? 7. And what is A2 value? 11. What we can get? 7 plus 11 means 18. So we got S2 value as 18 here and A2 is 11. So A2 is not equal to S2. But always A1 is equals to S1 only. Because A1 is the first term, S1 is the sum of first term only. Means we will get first term only directly, 7 only. Therefore A1 is equal to S1. But we cannot say A2 is equal to S2, because here in this example A2 is 11 and we got S2 value as S2 means A1, sum of first two terms means A1 plus A2, we got value as 18, therefore A2 is not equal to S2. Okay, so now in question what they are asking, what is the first term? So to calculate A1, can I write here S1? Because S1 is also equals to A1, so directly I will calculate S1 value here, because they have given in, they have given Sn value. So now what they are asking again? What is the sum of first two terms? Means we have to calculate S2 also. What is the second term? Means A2. Similarly, find third, tenth. What they are asking? Second term A2, find third, tenth, and an term. So here in question what they have given, sum of n terms as 4n minus n square. Here we have to calculate a1 value, means s1 value, because we all know a1 is equal to s1, and they are asking s2 also, means sum of first two terms, and we have to calculate a2, a3, a10 values. Also we have to find an value also. So now to calculate s1 value, they have given here sn value. So here easily I can calculate s1 value. So I will consider s1 as sn value, therefore n value is equals to 1. Here I can write 4 into 1, because the n value is 1 minus n square means 1 square. Right. Now 4 into 1 means 4 minus 1 square means how much I will get? 1 square means 1 only. 4 minus 1 means 3. So now like this only I will calculate, and we all know S1 is equal to A1 or A1 is equal to S1. So now we have calculated S1 value, and this is also equals to A1. So this is A1 also. Right. Now I will calculate S2 value. To calculate S2 value, I will consider n value as 2 only. So here I will write 4n means 4 into 2 minus n square means 2 square, because n value is 2 here, 4 into 2 8 minus 2 square means 4, 8 minus 4 means 4. So S1 value is 3 and 12, S1 value is 3 and S2 value is 4. Here S1 means A1 only, always S1 equals to A1. Therefore we got A1 value also, so A1 is also equals to 3. Now we got the value of S2, which is equals to 4. So now we have to calculate A2 value. But we all know A2 is not equal to this S2 value, because S2 is the sum of first two terms, means A1 plus A2. So here what is A1 value? Sorry, we are calculating A2 value. So to calculate A2 value, what we can do? Here it is S2, A2 is equal to, I will move this A1 to the other side. Therefore, A2, S2 minus A1. S2 means sum of first two terms, A1 plus A2. And here we have to calculate A2, second term. How to calculate second term? A2 is equal to I will move this A1 to the other side, therefore S2 minus A1, right? So here, what is the S2 value that we got? 4. S2 is 4 minus A1. A1 value is 3. 4 minus 3. Therefore, A2 value is 4 minus 3 means 1. Now we got the S1 value, S2 value, A1 and A2 values. So now what we can do? I will find out An value directly so that I can easily find out A3 and A10 values. How to calculate An value? By using the formula An is equal to A plus N minus 1 into B. So here we are calculating An value, means N value is N only, because we are calculating An value. And here A means first term. What is the first term in this series? 3. A1 is 3. So here in the place of A I will write 3, and N value is N only, because we are calculating Anth value only, N minus 1 into D value. So now what is the D value here? To calculate D value, what we can do? D is equals to A2 minus A1. We can calculate D value. So what is the D value? A2 is 1 minus A1 value is, what is the A1 value? 3. 1 minus 3 means, what is the D value? So plus into minus, minus 3 minus 1 means 2, and the sign in front of bigger value is minus, therefore D value is minus 2. Here I will write minus 2, right? So now what we can do? I will multiply this minus 2 with N minus 1. So 3 into minus 2 into N means minus 2N, minus 2 into N means minus 2N, and minus 2 into minus 1 means minus 2 into minus 1 means minus into minus plus. So 2 into 1, 2. So 3 minus 2N plus 2. So now in next step, what we can do? I will add 2 to 3. 3 plus 2 means how much I will get? 5 minus 2N. So this is the nth term value, 5 minus 2N. So now I can easily calculate A3 and A10 value, because already we have calculated A1 and A2 values. Now I will calculate A3 value. Here N value is 3, therefore 5 minus 2 into N value is 3 only. So here 5 minus 2 into 3 means 6. 5 minus 6 means how much I will get? Minus 1. Like that only I have to calculate A10 value. A10 is equal to, so N value is 10 here, 5 minus 2 into 10, which is equal to 5 minus 2 into 10 means 20. 5 minus 20 means plus into minus, minus 20 minus 5 means 15 I will get, and the sign in front of the bigger one is minus, therefore the answer is minus 15. So this is, these are the values of A3 and A10. So here in this problem, what they have given? Sum of n terms, means Sn value as 4n minus n square, and we have to calculate S1 and S2 values, and also we have to calculate A1, A2, A3, A10, and also we have to find out An term. So now to calculate A1 or S1, I will consider n value as 1, S1 is equal to 4 into the place of n. I will consider n value as 1, 4 into 1 minus n square means 1 square. We got the value of S1 as 3. And we all know S1 is equal to A1. S1 means sum of
first term and a1 means first term. So always a1 is equal to s1. So a1 value is also 3 now. Now we will calculate s2 value. So here n value is 2, means here 4 into 2 minus n square means 2 square. 4 into 2 minus 2 square means we got the s2 value also 4. So now I will calculate a2 value. Because we have the a1 value, now we have to calculate a2. We cannot say s2 is equal to a2, because s2 is the sum of first two terms and a2 is the second term of the series. So now we are calculating a2. So s2 is equal to always equal to sum of first two terms, a1 plus a2. So here we can write to calculate a2. I will move this a1 to the other side. A2 is equal to s2 minus a1. So now s2 value is 4 and minus a1 value is 3. 4 minus 3 means 1. Now I will calculate d value by using a1 and a2. D is equal to a2 minus a1, and we have the a2 value as 1 and a3 value is 3. So 1 minus 3 means minus 2 is the d value. Now we can calculate a n term directly, so that we can easily calculate a3 and a10 values. So now here I will calculate a n term value. Therefore n value is n only, because we are calculating a n term. Therefore a n is equal to a plus n minus 1 into d is the formula. Here we have a value as 3 and plus n, means here n value is n only, n minus 1, d value is minus 2. Here I will multiply minus 2 to the n minus 1. So here finally we got the anth term as 5 minus 2n. This is the anth term. Now we can easily calculate this a3 and a10 values. Okay. So now a3 is equal to 5 minus 2 into n value is 3 here, 2 into 3. So a3 value is minus 1. Like that only I will calculate a10 value. I got the a10 value as minus 15. Okay. I hope you all are clear with these problems. In next class, I will continue with further problems. Thank you all.